Speed kills have always been something special in RuneScape. From the earliest records, to the insanely fast times we see today, players have always found ways of killing something faster than before. The knowledge that players have gained over the years has been huge, and the intricate rotations that have been crafted along the way have always amazed people. Some players have loved finding skips at bosses for huge time saves. Some have enjoyed dealing large amounts of damage with very precise setups. And others have enjoyed waiting on Phase 2 Virago. But for me, my favourite boss to speed kill has always been Vindictor. There are no mechanics, no skips, no time gates. It's just turn up and do as much damage as you can until it dies. This is the history of Vindictor speed kills. The first recorded record was set by Rachel on the 13th of May 2016. This was a 46 second kill. This kill used a Dragon Battle Axe spec before the kill, but other than that, there was no setup. The rotation used was reasonably simple, starting off with Tendrils and Slaughter before moving into a Berserk rotation. This rotation consisted of Assault and Destroy with a few other basics. After Berserk had ended, they again used Slaughter before finishing off Vindictor with a few more basics. When this time was set, there were very few uses for Adrenaline, and although this kill was reasonably quick, we knew that it would be swiftly beaten. And beaten swiftly it was. The very next day, a player by the name of Brett dropped a 39 second kill time. This kill had a lot of improvements over the previous record. He used a mage switch to Voln Vindictor before switching to melee and casting Slaughter. He then built up to Berserk much sooner, which he used with Planted Feet. This meant that his Berserk would last 5 seconds longer, hence why he was able to Zerk much earlier. Due to his longer Zerk, he was able to deal a lot more damage in his Zerk, and despite losing a few ticks, killed it swiftly after his Zerk had ended with a Slaughter followed by a Hurricane. At this point, people weren't really sure whether to start with a Berserk or with Bleeds. If you started with a Berserk, you could benefit from good RNG in your Berserk, and you could probably get some of your thresholds off twice in the kill, like Assault and Hurricane. But if you started off with Bleeds, you were able to use Vaughn with almost no damage loss, and you were able to gain the full effect of Bleeds, so your overall damage could be higher, but you couldn't use most of your thresholds twice. This is a pretty important choice, so what would happen if you did start with Berserk? Well, that's exactly what this kill tried. RSN Jig decided that he was going to start off with a Berserk, his plan being to try and use Hurricane twice within the kill. Crucially, starting off with Berserk also meant that the first 20 seconds was where the majority of his damage was, meaning that he could utilize Berserk Blood Essence. Berserk Blood Essence hadn't been used up till now, and it provided a significant damage boost while active. The downside was that when it ran out 25 seconds into the fight, his damage would be lower, but as long as the last bit of HP didn't take too long, he should be able to pull off a good kill, which is exactly what he did, finishing off the kill with a second Hurricane. Now, Planted Feet Zerk seemed to be a big boost, and was definitely beneficial, but no player had really utilized the extra time that Berserk gave you, and that's because they are missing a key piece. On the 14th of November 2016, Jerx released Adrenaline Crystals. These are a herbal ingredient that can increase the adrenaline gained from replenishment potions from 25 to 30. Now, this boost didn't seem like much at the time, but one player realized the potential. This player was You Got Lit Up, a very good player who had completed countless PVM feats and speed kills. He had realized that with this extra 5 adrenaline, he was able to destroy very early in his Berserk, and due to the 20 second cooldown that this ability had, he was able to Hurricane right at the end of his Berserk, giving him a huge damage boost. This idea worked perfectly, and with a Slaughter and Tendrils right after Berserk ended, he was able to secure a time of 34 seconds. But this strategy was short-lived. This record stood for just under 2 months before Jerx removed Planted Feet from Berserk. This meant that the previous few kills were invalid, and all the knowledge that had been gained towards these rotations was out the window. The record was back to where we started, a 46 seconds from Rachel. Over the next few months, not a lot happened. A 43 second kill time was obtained, a 42, and a 39. But these are small improvements with no rotational changes or new ideas. But just like before, we were preparing for a big jump, all the way down to 34 seconds. B had entered the leaderboard, a player that was very accustomed to Gobble's Dungeon 2 records, thought he'd try his hand at Vindictor. Similar to Let's Kill, he started off with an early destroy, meaning he was able to do another destroy within his kill. But crucially, he wasn't baited by using Quake. Quake was an ability that almost every record up till now had used, and although it's a threshold, the damage was reasonably low. Players were spending adrenaline that they couldn't really afford to be spending. Because B hadn't fallen into this trap, his post-Berserk rotation was almost flawless, allowing him to use both his bleeds and a destroy in quick succession. This kill would definitely take some beating. So it was time for a buff, a new item, something to spice things up. The Limitless Sigil. This item revolutionized the way speed killing was done, and has to this day. This allowed players to use thresholds below 50% adrenaline, provided that they had the adrenaline required for the threshold. This meant that they could perform a very similar rotation to Beast Kill, with almost instant thresholds after Berserk. Introducing Tommy 43, better known as Hellwhip Pleb, one of the most well-known speed killers now, but very new to the scene back then. Armed with a scythe, a limitless sigil worth of debt, and a dream, he rose to the occasion. Executing his rotation perfectly, he was able to complete a very fast post-berserk rotation, ensuring a 33-second kill time was in the bag. The general rotation had been formed. Start off with a berserk, drops from thresholds. After your berserk ends, use your bleeds and another threshold, hoping that you've done just enough damage to kill it. And this rotation was exactly what was used for Chewie's 31-second Vindictor and Hellwhip Pleb's 29-second. Pleb had used a few extra things such as Vengeance and Portents of Degradation to eke out a little more damage, but this rotation had run its course. Starting with the Berserk and ending with the Bleeds seemed great, but as the kill times got faster and faster, those Bleeds were doing less and less damage. Something needed to change. Deep in the depths of the Dutch wilderness, something was brewing. A something called Night Eyes. He realised that this rotation was no good, and had reverted back to the old strat of starting off with Bleeds. But his kill had a few tweaks. Just like Brett almost 2 years ago, he started off his kill with a vulnerability switch, before going straight into a slaughter, tendrils and dismember. Now normally at this point you would build to Berserk, but this was going to take too long, and would mean your Berserk would end too late. So Night Eyes did something that no one had really thought about before. He used his adrenaline potion to build up to Berserk. This meant that he could Berserk way earlier than other players, but had much less adrenaline in his Berserk. But that wasn't an issue. Utilizing his limitless sigil, he was able to get off both his assault and destroy. But that wasn't it. He ended the kill with a Vesta's Longsword spec, something that hadn't been considered before. In this kill, he got unlucky. His VLS didn't kill it, and the boss died 2 ticks late, equaling the record. But this had changed the way records would be done, and how rotations would be viewed. Or so we thought. Night Eyes had gotten this kill in March, and nothing had happened for a few months. We all assumed Hellwhip Pleb was happy with his 29-second first place. But little did we know that he was cooking up something huge. Something that would blow people's minds, and redefine what it was to be a speed killer. On the 9th of July, Pleb uploaded a 27-second kill. Now although the time was impressive, it wasn't even close compared to the rotation. Hellwhip Pleb had decided that he was going to onslaught down Vindictor from 180,000 health. Pleb had actually done a setup kill, placing 3 Prisms of Loyalty and filling them all up. As Vindictor spawned, he vulned, used a 2-hit assault into Slaughter, before using his A-Pot into Onslaught. This Onslaught would last for the whole kill. With the help from his Prisms, his Vampiric Essence, and his Sign of Death, he was able to clutch out one of the most insane speed kills to date. Although this kill couldn't really be improved on, and the rotation was reasonably set in stone, he had shown players that sometimes thinking outside the box is exactly what you need to make a kill work. This kill has stood as one of the most insane speed kills, and despite there being much faster kills, this had shown that you could kill a boss any way you wanted. On the 13th of August, a big update came out. One that had changed melee rotations for years, and would provide upgrades that would be used for years to come. The Dragonkin Laboratory. With this update came 3 new melee abilities. Greater Fury, Greater Flurry, and most importantly, Greater Barge. Greater Barge was very good, and it allowed the player to use one of their channel thresholds as a bleed. The caveat was that the player had to not be attacking a target for 8 ticks, meaning that this couldn't be used in the middle of a rotation without offing the boss. A player called Nummy Tacos and myself had decided that with the right rotation, a 26-second kill time could be achieved, and we set out theorycrafting a rotation, but there were a few issues. If we started with a Berserk and a Greater Barge, our Berserk wouldn't do enough damage to kill Vindictor. And ending with bleeds was very bad as the time taken for them to fully deal their damage was too long. But if we started with bleeds into a berserk with barge, we'd then have to stop attacking Vindictor in the middle of the fight, costing a huge amount of time. This discussion continued between us back and forth for a while, before I had an idea. What if we just didn't use barge? Although mutated barge was very powerful, berserk just didn't have the damage to make the full use of it, so we decided against it. And with that in mind, we set out for a 26-second. Using almost exactly the same rotation as Night Eyes kill a few months earlier. And almost instantly, Nummy Tacos had results, a 26-second kill. Despite only critting a few hits, he was consistently hitting over 9k with each hit, netting him huge amounts of damage in his Berserk. And with his VLS KO critting, he cemented his place at the top of the leaderboard. This kill was seen as the pinnacle. Skipping the dismember before Berserk, and KOing Vindictor with his VLS, meant that there was no time save with this rotation. It had run its course. Hewlett-Packard wasn't too happy that someone had taken his record, but this 26-second kill seemed almost unbeatable. The RNG needed to kill it earlier in Zerk was impossible, and it was very hard to fit a barge in after the bleeds. But no one had been able to utilize Greater Barge or Greater Flurry. They just didn't fit into the current rotation. But what if you completely rethought your rotation? And that's exactly what Hewlett-Packard did. An ideal kill would Zerk start with Greater Barge and completely eliminate out of Zerk bleeds. But it was impossible to deal 200k damage in the Zerk. You needed something to boost your damage, something to give you a major edge. And that something was Revenge. Pleb realized that he could stack 10 mobs by the Vindictor entrance. Then after dropping combat, he could use Revenge for no Adren cost, giving him 10 Revenge stacks for the first 7 seconds of the fight. This allowed him to use Flurry under Revenge, meaning that the originally not great threshold was able to hit the hit cap pretty consistently. Combined with a 4 tick Voln switch post barge, he was able to secure a very high damage Berserk, resulting in a 22 second kill. He also obtained another 2 20 second kill of the same time. Unfortunately, both of these kills could have been a few ticks faster, given more ideal conditions or procs that he was aiming for, such as Sign of Death or Crackling. But the time set was so impressive that these small ticks lost felt insignificant. This had started a new era. No more would you need to use bleeds. No more would you need to worry about your Berserk placement within the kill. This was the turning point for rotations. A simple defensive threshold had made all the difference. But Pleb's kill was insane. The RNG needed was far off what people were prepared for, and as such, this time stood for just under a year. But Namitakos wasn't done. He knew that with a perfect kill, the time could be cut down by 1.8 seconds, finishing the kill on the very last tick of Berserk, something that Hewlett-Packard had been unable to complete. And on the 6th of September 2019, Nami achieved this kill. Although the build was slightly different from Pleb's, the Revenge strat was still used, and with almost every hit being a 10k or higher, he was able to complete the kill within Berserk, obtaining that 20 second time he was aiming for. Nami's rotation and damage was almost perfect. Every ability used was a very high damaging threshold, or a basic used for adrenaline gain. But Vindictor hadn't died to his VLS spec at the end. He needed to kill it with a basic at the very end of his Berserk. And although this kill had some of the highest hitsplats seen, everyone knew that if you could kill Vindictor with that VLS, an 18 second was on the cards. And one player rose to the challenge, Unstable. This was a kill of immense RNG. Taking Nami's rotation and adopting the same strat of Revenge, he was able to secure an 18 second kill, finishing off Vindictor with his VLS spec. The hits in this kill were insane, with only a few low rolls. This was going to be the record to beat. And the only way to beat it would be to change the rotation yet again. Something major had been missing from these last few kills, and that was stalling. Stalling means using an ability before the boss has spawned, but not letting your character actually cast it on the target. You can then release it on the boss when it spawns along with another ability, effectively giving you an extra global cooldown. This means you can do one extra ability compared to normal. Stalling is something that has been used in many records up till now, such as this Bandos. But there was a problem here. If you stalled an ability, you wouldn't be able to release it and also use Greater Barge. The stalled ability would put you in combat, meaning you wouldn't be able to gain the Greater Barge buff. So you needed to use the barge before the boss spawned, on something like a dummy. This is what Fina had decided he was going to do. He barged the dummy before the boss spawned, then stalled his Decimate here. This meant that he could instantly attack Vindictor with his stalled ability and his Flurry Bleed, gaining him a little extra damage. He knew that with the correct rotation, he'd be able to beat that 18 second kill. Firstly, he continued the revenge idea, and combined with his pre-barge meant that his early damage was very high. Right at the end of his revenge, he used a Dragon Dagger special attack, something that hadn't been used up till now, but within revenge was very powerful. After this, he used a full assault into a basic and his last threshold, hoping to get that 16 second kill time. He was so close, but just didn't have the damage, and although he had equaled the world record, that wasn't enough for him. So he went back. And again, another 18 second. Surely this would be the kill. But it wasn't. Despite his rotation being vastly superior to the current record, he was only able to match it, obtaining 3 18 second kills. So it was time to put someone in that really knew his stuff. Someone that was about to show Fina how it was done. Someone that would let him know about his failure for years to come. Me. Or well, not really me. War's Retreat. War's Retreat was added to the game on the 27th of January 2020, and with it came the Adrenaline Crystal. This changed the way players built Adren before fights, and we quickly realised that it would be used for crit rotations. A crit rotation means using something like Meteor Strike before the kill, so that during the kill, when you crit, you'll gain 10% Adrenaline. This means you can cast a lot of thresholds and some special attacks without needing to use basics much for Adren. A few months later, Archaeology also came out, and with it the Berserker's Fury Relic. This relic allowed players to deal extra damage the lower HP they were, netting around a 5% damage increase. It was time to juice. And on the 20th of April, I obtained this 17 second kill. The rotation was pretty simple, as I was testing out the crit build, so no pre-barge or stalling was used. Being able to add in a Dragon Claws as well as a Granite Maul special attack meant that the damage I was able to output was insane. Under 24 hours later, I got this 16 second kill. The rotation was very similar, just with a little less adrenaline. For these kills, I was using a Steel Titan. Although Archaeology had introduced a new best in slot familiar, the Ripper Demon, this familiar was bugged on release, so I had decided to avoid it. But these kills were just stepping stones. The real aim was something much faster. And just 1 week later, this kill happened. A 13 second Vindictor kill. A huge jump from 18 seconds. This was insane at the time, and is a kill that still personally impresses me to this day. The fact that unusual things like Slaughter during Berserk were used because it was the best threshold left, and finishing the kill with a double G-Maul was mental. The crits I had gotten in this kill really brought something new to the table adrenaline wise, and was definitely a leap forward from the more conventional Berserk rotation that had been used up until now. But something big was about to happen. Something that had changed bossing as a whole, and is probably the biggest change to speed kills to this day. The Essence of Finality. The Essence of Finality is an amulet that can hold the special attack of any weapon. This meant that you could cast specs such as Dragon Claws or Dark Bow with your normal weapons equipped, changing what were low tier spec weapons at level 70 to high tier 92 special attacks, dealing vastly more damage than originally able to. We knew that combined with Natural Instinct for increased adrenaline gain and the crit buff, special attacks would now become the backbone of short speed kills, dealing more damage than the vast majority of other abilities. And just 1 week after this item had been introduced, a player by the name of Wave Goodbye dropped this mental kill, an 11 second Vindictor, with 4 high damaging Dragon Claw specs. With an Assault Bleed, a 2 hit Flurry and a Hurricane KO, he executed what looked to be an unbeatable time, not a single basic ability used, every second filled with damage. And when I saw this kill, I was amazed, but sad. I knew that this kill was going to be very, very hard to beat. I knew that it was possible with a revenge setup, but I hadn't done that before, and I knew I would struggle. So I decided to try something a little different. Essence of Finality meant that any spec could be cast with a weapon of the same style. This meant that while ranging, people were often casting the Siren Godbow special attack with ECB, for the chance of a Ruby Bolt proc. This would massively increase the damage of the SGB without the need for Death Swiftness or range gear. So my plan was simple, get a Ruby Bolt proc on an SGB. But this wasn't that easy. The chance of a Ruby proc was 8.4%, and because it would need to be my first ability of the fight, this meant I'd be casting it on a 3x3 Vindictor. This meant the chance to get at least a 3 arrow Ruby SGB, which is what I needed, was a 1 in 26. This meant that the amount of realistic attempts I'd be getting an hour was around 2. Combining this with the crits needed on the SGB as well as high damaging melee crits, this would take me a while. Or, I thought. But not too long after starting attempts, I got a kill where everything lined up. As well as using the Ruby SGB, my rotation was very similar to Wave Goodbye's. I was using a few Dragon Claw specs, an Assault Bleed, and ending on a Hurricane KO, with a G-Maul if Adren was there. And despite the first hits of this kill looking awful, the second half carried into what was the first sub 10 Vindictor. For a few months this kill remained number 1, and I knew that with the right RNG, I could go back and beat it. The crits throughout this kill hadn't been that great, and it didn't seem that bad to beat. So a few months later, I was back grinding. These attempts used almost exactly the same rotation as the 9 seconds, the only difference being one Dragon Claws was removed. And around 20 hours into attempts, a 7 second kill was obtained. This kill had provided one of my favourite speed kill screenshots, a 5-hour Ruby SGB with many high crits, and along with even timing my crackling, this kill was cemented as first place. But something bothered me. On the last tick, I was able to do a Hurricane and a Granite Morspec, a combination capable of dealing 40,000 damage. But Vindicta only had 18k health left. I had dealt too much damage, and I knew that I could push for better. I knew that I could remove another Dragon Claw spec to save 1.8 seconds and secure a 6 second kill, but this also meant I'd be removing an assault hit. But with enough crits, I knew that it was possible. 6 months later, I was back at Vindicta, hunting that 6 second. I had added in a few extra Gemmals to the rotation to try and make up the damage I'd be losing, and I knew that with the right RNG, this kill would happen. But no one knew just how bad that RNG would be. I tried this kill for hours, and hours, and hours. I spent weeks, months at this boss. I had accumulated over 100 hours of attempts, trying to save just 1 second. I had never spent anything close to this long on a speed kill before, and still haven't to this day. I was so close so many times, but fell short.
Please die. Nah. 3-hour SGB, and I'm 7k off.
Something that had started off as a declaw spam now only included one declaw spec. The rotation was so short that it felt impossible to do 200k damage in that time span. I now needed an SGB rare enough that I could go hours without getting one. But 120 hours into my attempts, on the 23rd of September 2021, it happened. Everything had lined up. The kill that initially seemed relatively easy, that had turned into the RNG fest of a lifetime, had finally been done. The last tick of the kill was pretty impressive, with 68k damage dealt, finishing off with a triple Gemmal and Hurricane. This record was the longest standing Vindicta record. I had even surprised myself by how long it took to get, and I swore I'd never do another Ruby SGB record again. At this point in the game, melee was firmly regarded as the worst style. It was easily outclassed by ranged and magic, and if you rolled up to a group boss with melee, you weren't on the team anymore. Jagex had realised this, and so with the release of Zamorak, melee received a brand new armour set, the Vestments of Havoc. The Vestments of Havoc is a new best-in-slot armour set, with slightly better stats over Trim Masterwork. But what makes it really good is that it increases your maximum adrenaline. This means you can have 130% adrenaline as opposed to 110, allowing you to fit in extra Gemmals and benefit from extra crit adrenaline. This is very important because at this point I knew I would never use Ruby SGB again. I knew that I needed to have a totally different strategy. And that's what this kill was. The 4 second Vindicta. Vindicta has a 1.8 second spawn time, meaning that this is actually only 2.4 seconds worth of damage. Because of this short time span, a large portion of the rotation was made up of Granite Morspecs, an off global cooldown special attack with a large adren cost. To sustain this, I had Natural Instinct and a crit buff active for 20% adrenaline refund per crit. The build for this kill was a lot more technical. The setup was perfectly timed so that I'd get crackling and an aftershock proc within the kill. 9 minions were stacked up so that I could get a Jazzbuck proc as well as Ruthless stacks before the fight. And because I wasn't switching any weapons, I was able to use the Annihilation buff. All of this meant that once the RNG was there, the kill looked like this. Such a huge amount of damage that some of the hits aren't even visible. The rotation for this was a stalled Hurricane, released into a triple Gemmal and an Overpower, finishing off with a Havoc triple Gemmal. It's obvious from this rotation that we've pretty much hit the limit of what is possible at Vind. But this 2 global cooldown can be beaten. Combining the 1.8 second spawn time with a 0.6 second kill could give you a 2.4 second Vindicta time. Bringing us on to the one tick. Lots of bosses have been one-ticked over the years, starting with Bandos, to Zilyana, and even Korb. But nothing with this much HP has ever been killed with a one-tick melee rotation. But 3 months after my 4-second kill, I had formed a setup and rotation that I knew had the potential. The setup was very similar to the previous kill, but some key differences were added. First, twice as many minions were stacked up, so that I could build Scripture of Jazz damage on them rather than on the boss. I used Revenge on the minions so that my max hit could be significantly higher, and the boss rotation was completely different. There was no overpower, no hurricane. It was now a stalled Dragon Claws released into a large amount of Granite Maul Specs, accompanied by a Havoc. With all the buffs I had available, my Granite Maul Specs were able to do over 19,000 damage. But to get this kill, I needed to crit basically everything. Each crit generated 20 adrenaline, which allowed me to perform my next special attack. If I didn't crit, the rotation couldn't be executed. And with the knowledge that this could be the last time I'd be speed killing Vindicta, I started attempts. And 10 hours in, something happened. A 3-second kill. I had gotten the crits I needed. I had gotten the crit RNG needed. But my Scripture of Jazz had procced one tick too late on the minions. This meant that although I had enough damage to get the kill, and had executed it perfectly, Vindicta died at 3 seconds to my Jazz Book. One tick too slow. Not the 2.4 that I was chasing. This was demotivating to see, but I wasn't going to give up. So many hours of speed killing Vindicta. From Pleb's insane onslaught kill, to the first Berserk only kill, the first Granite Maul use at Vindicta, an introduction of EOFs and the crit meta, the stupid RNG from Ruby SGB, all led up to this point. An unbeatable kill. It's insane to think that Vindicta has now been completed. No new world record will be submitted. No new timer will be broken. It was a joy to see the huge progression we've had over the years, and the knowledge we have gained. The journey that speeds have come on is immense, and I hope it continues that way. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.